Hey guys, it's Dane here, Dane Winchester. There's been a misunderstanding. Of course, you've probably known what I've been going through. Lost my little brother Sam. Lost my dad. Yeah. Not looking too good. I know the evil son of a bitch that killed him. Jeff, if you're watching this, you are so dead. But I can't be the one to strike it down and kill you. That's Jane's thing. Speaking of Jane, sorry about what I've been thinking of you. What happened was, about 2 years ago, what I thought was Jane stabbed me in the back and killed me. But somehow Jeff was camouflaged. And I'm gonna find out what. I'm gonna kill it. That one's mine. That's mine, Jane. If you're watching this. Yeah. I hope you and I can maybe become the best of friends one day. But yeah, regardless, I recently found out that she shares a YouTube channel with a person named Rara Kitsune. And here's her latest video. Jane the Killer reacts to Fanfictions. Is this seriously what you do with your life? Why do you give a crap what people have to say? Alright, you know what? Let's just get this over with. 3, 2, 1, go.
This is a quick reminder to say that this is not intended to insult or make fun of anyone's content. I'd like to say that this is satire and not in any way serious. Thank you!
Demon art scares me sometimes.
Of course it's scary. What else is more terrifying?
React to Wattpad.
Wattpad?
You mean the sanitary pads?
Go to Wattpad to read fanfics. You'll love it.
Not.
I tried to read a fanfic on DeviantArt. Could this potentially be worse?
Oh, James.
What are these?
Jane, this isn't as bad DeviantArt? As Wattpad. I've seen some terrifying things on Jane X Jeff.
Lemon?
What Slenderman's existence are you talking about?
Slenderman, huh?
It? Huh. Looks kind of boring. Mephisto X Reader?
I wonder who's responsible for reading that.
Is that Lara?
Weird. React to Jane X Jeff Lemon fanfics.
What are these lemon? Where's the lemon in this?
I'll read these Wattpad fanfics or whatever they're called. This is gonna be interesting.
Oh boy.
Hello, my little creepsters. It's Jane the Killer here.
Welcome
hey, Jane.
Back to another reaction.
Hey, she's got a knife too.
I'm here to take on your request as to what I should react to.
Unfortunately, this time I am reacting to fanfics on, Wattpad. Thanks for the, request.
What is Wattpad?
I really appreciate it.
Wattpad.
Okay, first of all, what Wattpad. Would happen if I was to put in my own name? So, if I put Jane the Killer. My gosh, there's quite a few of them. Jane X Reader, Jane X Male Reader, Jane.
There's gotta be
Jeff.
Some erotic stuff.
You know how I feel about that.
Jane X Jeff.
I'm pretty nervous.
Who does that?
To read these. This is not gonna be good.
Well, since I'm here, I am definitely going to search for Jane the Killer X Jeff the Killer to start off with.
Really?
What a great
what are you doing to yourself, Jane?
Wonder which one I should choose to read first. Look at this, even my, wait, hold on a second. Jane Arkansas, that's not my last name. It's Jane Richardson for your information, bub. Let's go
really?
Back to the top. Maybe I should
Richardson,
go
huh?
on the first one. I hope it isn't too long. Let's see what the plot is. So, Jane and Jeff the Killer from How They Met, to them falling in love and into marriage. Then something amazing happens. People never thought would imagine.
Can't stop yawning.
Sounds like a generic romance story, right? It was a cold winter night. Jane had just had a plan to go out and find Jeff. Her friends and family was his victims, unfortunately, which made her mad enough to go out with her killing herself just to find him. Yeah, that's my hobby, all right. Jane, she was a sweet, sweet girl, 18 years old, a senior in high school, long wavy brown hair, not anymore.
No.
Dark green eyes, not anymore either. Clumsy, and was never really the popular one. Oh, joy, I sound like the main character from an anime. She loved
her family so much.
Oh, I dearly did until they died. Her younger brother and nephew. Wait, what? I had no idea I had a brother. Was there something my mom didn't tell me?
You all know I had a brother.
He would cook himself his own food of ramen noodles and lock himself in his room all day.
Ramen noodles?
Ramen noodles? Really? Now I feel like I'm in the real anime!
She and I say that at the same time.
He was 7 years old, was always outside hanging out with his friends. Well, at least he had some friends. Jeff was always a loser. He hated being alone most of the time. Oh, poor Jeffy Leffy. Who cares? One day at school, Steven went to Jeff and started pushing him against lockers. I think Steven should be replaced with me. Well, anyways, let's get to class. Second period is starting in about 3 minutes. We've got to get going. Jane pointed out while she grabbed his hand and started running to class across campus. That is not me. I would never willingly grab his hand to go and fly across campus just to go to class. This makes me so mad already. Jane and Jeff seemed to be blushing a bit when the words from this girl, Caitlin, said, "Aw, you two look so cute together." They didn't say anything back to her, but look at each other and blush. Look at my face right now. Do I look like I would ever blush considering the paleness of my skin? It's not gonna work, guys. I can't even read fanfiction properly. I just can't finish one. I guess there was one thing that I did learn about fanfictions, though.
What's that?
One-shots. One-shots are just short stories, basically. Usually they last at least one paragraph, I guess. But yeah,
that is pretty short.
Try that. How about Jane X Laughing Jack? Oh, goody goody, I found one. But first,
who's Laughing Jack?
Down the page a bit more, so we may find something a little bit more descriptive.
Oh yeah, if you're wondering why there's blood on my shirt, before I got back, I had to take care of a vampire infestation.
That's embarrassing for Jeff.
Jane's lost it.
God, that's hilarious! So funny. Okay, let's go back to the top. Let's go for the jacket.
I hope Jeff sees this.
A girl named Jane had a depressing life after her parents died, but then all of that is about to change by one simple box. So she picked it up and takes it to her house, where something jumps out from the colorful box that Jane just dried with a cloth that her mother gives her as a present to remember them. Intriguing to see two stories become one, or should I say two become one. When two become one. There was one night that I couldn't forget. It was a night that wouldn't end. I was walking home from college and I tripped over something big and fell to the ground. My left knee burst. In fact, I didn't feel anything because I couldn't.
Slow down, Jane.
I'm sorry, guys.
Really?
That's where things get really creepy. I heard a voice saying stuff about my parents and then this box started to shake inside of my hoodie. So I dashed up to my room and gently popped the box on my bed and went to go and change my shirt because it was so. Just then the box started to play the main Jack in the Box.
Why was your shirt soaked?
But what did the puppet look like? That's what concerned me. Until a puff of smoke came gushing out of the box and I saw a strange presence. Presence. There's a bit of a typo here. I saw a strange presence somehow from the box. The person was nearly the same height as me, but she. And then I finally managed to figure out who said that he was not like any Jack in the Box I have ever seen he was wearing.
What?
I have no words. He wasn't like any old Jack in the Box. He was a Jack who needed someone to murder? Who? Huh?
What's that face? What is that face?
I'm so confused right now. What?
And yeah, as if that face didn't say anything.
Stab the knife in my chest. Stab the knife in my chest. Oh, the grammar in this is just terrible. And Mom moved it down to the bottom of my stomach. Then he stretched my stomach apart, and all my organs started to fall out of my stomach, leaving an empty hole in my limp body on the floor. How wonderful! I am being torn apart. Great.
Don't do that!
It was really
sleep here. Now all of my organs are gone, and I'm starting to feel wobbly and pale, and any minute now, I might fall to my final breath and die from a clown that's just gutted me. Apparently, they call this a fanfiction. To be continued? What? Last updated September 7th, 2015? What the hell? That was like 3 years ago. I guess this is the problem with fanfictions, though. They just don't continue them. How sad. Actually, I'm pretty happy about that because that's one less fanfiction in the world. This is absolute chaos in my book. I get it? In my book? Because, reading fanfictions and stuff? Yeah.
Stop.
Shut up, Jane.
Get some help.
Let's try Jane X Eyeless Jack. I am not going to be searching Ben Drowned or Sally Williams, because, you know, they're children after all, and...
Good.
I am not searching it. I don't want my eyes to bleed any more than they already are. Jack. I forgot to put Jack in there. Oh, there is actually one right here. It's in two parts. Oh, come on, really? Eyeless Jackie's child reader? Are you guys insane? Well, I guess so, because I'm just as insane. Okay, I've looked through the I'm just gonna go right back to the top again.
You're not a pedophile.
This one. Hey guys, I made this story for you guys. I hope you like it. You got the word it. Okay, let's read it, since it's only a two-part story. Read this part, sorry.
Or maybe just a one-sentence story.
Huh? Where's the story?
Gone.
Let's...
Oh, there it is.
Okay. Wow, that is so unbelievably short. Jane was a beautiful girl. Oh, thanks. She was so, so nice. I think you may want to rephrase that. I'm not nice. And I think I loved her. I asked if she wanted to play Call of Duty with Ben. Call of Duty? Who plays that now? And we played, and she won. Oh, yeah, go me.
I play
I'm
it.
I'm the best gamer in all
sometimes,
of
okay.
None of the time. History. I didn't think she had it in her when we played. Then I offered if she would like to stay with us. She replied with a nod. You could see that she was blushing a lot. And I thought she was cute. Oh, stop. Stop, stop, stop!
I missed it, sorry. My mind's everywhere.
That Toby used to live in. And when we entered, I leaned in and kissed her. Whoa. And I asked if she would be my girlfriend. She said yes. What?
What?
Wait. I would never say yes to Eyeless Jack. In fact, I would say no to every single person out there. Except for... Thunderbolt? When we left the room, a bunch of our friends were playing Truth or Dare.
Slenderman,
played,
huh?
We went back to our room and I hugged her. And
I'm gonna get a lot of mileage out of this one.
Closed our eyes, you know, just repeated the sentence. And we kissed for what seemed like forever. And I never let her go. When she did pull away, she was blushing. My God, she was hot! Well, thanks for the compliments, I suppose. I guess that wasn't too bad. It wasn't as sexual as I thought it was going to be. I don't see mean Isles Jack even.
Okay, so apparently Jane has a dirty mind, too.
I want to take down that website. It's an atrocity. Besides, I think I'll reword Ben Drown's comments. Wattpad scares me a lot.
I think it has 500 likes.
Wait, what's this?
What's
I
what?
I guess it's not over yet. There's this one here called Jeff's a Pain in the Ass. A Jeff the Killer X Reader one-shot. Sounds exciting! One night on Jeff's killing spree, he finds a girl who actually doesn't mind dying. Not being inspired to kill her, Jeff left the useless girl alone and went back to the mansion for the night. A couple weeks later, Jeff is pestered by a somewhat familiar ghost.
Jeff lives in a mansion? I mean, Jeff. Slenderman lives in a mansion?
He didn't want to kill. Wow. Slenderman does not live in a mansion. For Christ's sakes, people. Whoever might.
Yeah, I thought he just lived in the woods.
You know, it's just. That just. Hurts my head. Look at all this. I really hope. Oh, this is gonna be too long. I quit. I'm done. Okay, guys. I just can't read them anymore. It's too much embarrassment for me. I just can't.
Jane?
Okay. I'm done. I'm just done. Okay. Okay, I'm back.
Okay.
I'm calmed out.
You sure?
I've had my moments. I'm definitely gonna move on now. I just can't take this anymore. It's too upsetting for me. Okay. Anyways, thanks
be your request, guys. I almost died again. I'm still dying on the inside, though. If you have any questions for my... Shut up, Ghostface!
Ghostface?
Please leave your requests down below. And I might just post another reaction video. And as always, like, comment, and please subscribe to me. Or else you won't wake up. So I'll see you next time. Bye. A big shout out to everyone for donating to my Patreon page.
Hey, there's
if you want to see behind the scenes, please consider becoming a Patreon today, as everything will be provided on my profile page. Also, if you want to see more from me,
guess she wasn't kidding when he called her his best friend. Well, that was something. This is what you do with your life, Jane. Huh? When you're not out hunting, Jeff. No, hold on. This is what you do in your spare time. When you're not hunting, Jeff. What kind of hobbies do you have, you weird man? Okay, you're weird. And that's coming from me. Well, she's done. I guess not too. See you.